everyone, and welcome to the first Fallout 2 video on my YouTube channel. Now, I am excited to play this game because I have heard more often than not that Fallout 2 is better than Fallout 1, even though, Fallout 1 took like 4 years to make, and this game only took like a year, and it might have helped out that not all of the team from Fallout 1 worked on Fallout 2. Interplay made the first Fallout game, and some of those employees either found it or were hired by Black Isle, and they made this game. These are the same people that also made Fallout New Vegas. They did become Obsidian later on. But yes, so let's begin with the intro, as always.
Give me a kiss to build a dream on.
In my imagination, we'll thrive upon that kiss. Sweetheart, I ask no more than this. A kiss to build a dream on. Give me a kiss before you leave me, and my imagination will feed my hungry heart. Leave me one thing before we part, a kiss to build a dream on. When I'm alone with my fancies, I'll be with you, weaving romances, making believe they're true. Oh, give me your lips for just a moment, and my imagination will make that moment live. Give me what you alone can give, a kiss to build a dream on.
Becoming part of the background radiation that blanketed the Earth. A quiet darkness fell across the planet, lasting many years. Few survived the devastation. Some had been fortunate enough to reach safety, taking shelter in great underground vaults. When the great darkness passed, these vaults opened, and their inhabitants emerged to begin their lives again. One of the northern tribes claims they are descended from one such vault. They hold that their founder and ancestor, one known as the Vault Dweller, once saved the world from a great evil. According to their legend, this evil arose in the far south. It corrupted all it touched, twisting men inside, turning them into beasts. Only through the bravery of this Vault Dweller was the evil destroyed. But in so doing, he lost many of his friends and suffered greatly, sacrificing much of himself to save the world. When at last he returned to the home he had fought so hard to protect, he was cast out, exiled. In confronting that which they feared, he had become something else in their eyes, and no longer their champion. Forsaken by his people, he strode into the wasteland. He traveled far to the north, until he came to the Great Canyons. There he founded a small village, Arroyo, where he lived out the rest of his years. And so, for a generation since its founding, Arroyo has lived in peace, its canyons sheltering it from the outside world. It is home. Your home. But the scars left by the war have not yet healed, and the earth has not forgotten.
All right. I do like that. You know, I do like that in the intro during the movie there, you had the little stuff on the screen like you would in an old movie. I do like that touch. Now, this is 98, or this game was made in 98, so I would think that maybe they would have that same kind of stuff in 98, but I don't know. Oh. I don't want to load game. You know, this is really funny. Like I said in Fallout 1, this save and this save are both my off-camera save. The one right here is going to get replaced. I basically have one health and I'm poisoned in that save. So, that's why I want two saves at all times, like I said before. Now, I'm not going to take this cookie cutter template here. I'm going to modify it. Just like I did last year, gotta make it 22, because that's how old Fallout 2 is. Last year, Fallout 1 was 22, but now, and I was thinking, on Friday, that since my character in Fallout 1, his name is Max Stone, since this is his grandson, the Chosen One, it's going to be more stone, assuming I have... Yes, I have enough space! I have enough space! Yes! The Legend of More Stone! Yes! I am so incredibly happy! Max Stone! We played as Max Stone in Fallout 1! Skip a generation, have that be Max Stone Jr., and then More Stone! Yes! It is so cheesy, but I love it! I absolutely love it. Okay, so, gifted, what is this? Oh yeah, that boosts my special, stats. But, So I could theoretically go to 11? No, I can't go to 11. Let's see. The skilled increases. I don't think I can have skilled and gifted at the same time. I can have skilled and gifted? I don't remember that being a thing. I don't remember this. I've made a character or two beforehand, and I didn't think that I could... I'm really thinking about making this character female. Might just stick with male. And go with a female character in, Fallout 3. Because I haven't heard of a girl called Moore before, so that wouldn't really make a whole lot of sense. I need to go over these again. Fast metabolism. I think I picked this one in Fallout 1. Five additional skill points. You don't gain as many extra abilities. Okay, I've got a... I don't have to pick these... I don't have to pick a second optional trait, but I feel like... One-hander? I mean, if I... That means that I would really only be able to... use melee weapons with one hand as well as a gun. Heavy-handed? I think I picked bruiser and heavy-handed. What about small frame? You're not quite as big as the other villagers, but that never slowed you down. Probably not. Bloody mess. Maybe. Kamikaze. By not paying attention to any threats, you can act a lot faster in turn. This lowers your armor class to just what you are wearing. Well, I never wore armor in Fallout 1. Fast shot. You don't have time to aim for a targeted attack because you attack faster than normal people. It costs one less action point for guns and thrown weapons. Chem Reliant. You're more easily influenced by chems. Your chance to be reliant by chem use is twice normal, but you recover faster from their ill effects. Good-natured. You study less combative skills as you are growing up. Your combat skills start at a lower level, but first aid, doctor, speech, and barter are substantially improved. Chem resistance. Chems only affect you half as long as normal. But your chance to be reliant is also only 50% of normal. Uh, jinxed. The good thing is that everyone around you has more critical failures in combat. The bad thing is, so do you. I don't know, I think that good-natured would be a very good trait, and fast metabolism would be too, if I was going for a pacifist run, or a pacifist build. But this is not that. This is not that at all. So, I don't care about that. At all. I don't care. Finesse. Your attacks show a lot of finesse. You don't do as much damage, but you cause more critical hits. I think I have this for critical hit guy. You swing harder, not better. Your attacks are very brutal, but lack finesse. You rarely cause a good critical, but you always do more melee damage. I think Bruiser is part of the reason why I had some low action points, because it says you may not hit as often, but they will feel it when you do. Your total action points are lowered, but your strength is increased. My strength is already 9, so I don't necessarily need that. I think Bloody Mess. I think that'd be good. And then, I'm not gonna go with throwing. I'm gonna go with Outdoorsman is one that I haven't seen. Gambling? Why isn't that one for Fallout New Vegas? I'm gonna go with speech, though. Let's see, if I wasn't gifted, then... Holy crap, melee weapons! Jesus! But yeah, melee weapons. That's good. Unarmed. Holy crap, what is that without gifted? 88. Oh my god. Melee weapons. I'm not picking throwing weapons. I'm not a big fan of throwing weapons in general. Okay, my special stats. I'm sorry I'm taking so long on the screen. I'm just trying to... I haven't built that many characters in Fallout 1 and 2. So I'm trying to build the best character that I want. Trying to build one that I absolutely want for what I want to do. Like I said, I'm trying to make sure I don't regret it later. Okay, armor class, action okay, melee damage 4. Get all that. I'm basically reading that right here. Armor class was 6. In the first game. Luck, charisma, endurance. I think that gives me a lot of action points. Also helps out with some skills. Yeah, the me being gifted helps out with the skills. See, strength. What if that went down? Oh. Yeah, that definitely... Can your melee damage go below 1? Oh, I can't make it lower than 2. Okay, I'm gonna stop messing around with this. I think that I think that I'm good.
Come in, chosen one. There are things you must know. The village is dying. The signs are everywhere. Withering crops. Dying Brahmin. Sick children. There is hope, however. A slim hope that few know of. The old discs speak of an item called the Garden of Eden Creation Kit. It is said it can bring life to the wasteland. This will be your quest if you prove yourself worthy. For that proof, you must first journey to the Temple of Trials. If you survive, come back to me. We will talk more. Our life is in your hands, chosen one. Prove yourself. Find the geck. Be our salvation.
Okay. I have also heard that the beginning of this game is really tough, but as you see from my saved games, I haven't made it past this point yet, so... I don't know yet! I'm still trying to get past... Yes, I want to override it. Goodbye, critical hit guy. Okay. So. Now I have the two save files that I want. Now it's time to go into the cave, or the temple. Okay. Yeah, there are giant ants in this temple. I don't exactly like it. You are in a dark, musty temple. Oh, it's just gonna regain action points? Come at me. There we go. Yes! Did it have anything on it? Right now. I want to look. See what it has. I don't think it has anything on it. I think I was out of combat, so I don't think that mattered. Come at me. You'll be in range for me to hit you, but you'll run out of action points by the time you even get to me. Oh boy, I missed three straight times. Can I stop missing? That's six straight times! Good gracious. This giant ant is just a pain. Jesus. Okay. There we go. That door's unlocked. There should be scorpions coming up soon. But yes, I think this is where I'm going to end off the video. I'm not gonna save over my other one in case I get into a sticky situation in here. I can always go back and load up the bottom one and go back to here, because that's what I should have done in Fallout 1, like I've mentioned before, but that didn't happen. So I failed. But I'm going to fix this game, and I'm going to finish this game. And yes, I'm still upset in myself for that, and I will probably be upset at myself for that for quite a while. And or if I actually do get to complete Fallout 1 on this channel one day. But yes, just as I said, this is where I'm going to end off today's video. And see us, guys! I do believe that will do it for this Fallout 2 video. And next Fallout 2 video, I will see you later. Goodbye, guys! Thank you all for watching.